I don't know what the deal is with this one. I don't know why it won't focus in very well. But all of the switches on the dash, the gauges on the dash, it's hard to see them, but they're actually little switches everywhere. The nitrous bottles. And such are aluminum panels. Now this is a Honda Civic engine that is mainly scratch built. The intake manifold is scratch built. The headers are on their way to being scratch built. I've got the flange pretty much made, and now I've just got to add the solder. This is another, this is a V8 I'm working on for a Ford F-150. This one here, I'm working on this F-150 here. So far I've got the top cut out, the door's hinged, doing a body drop on it. I've made the fender wells. The fit is pretty good. I mean, for the door and everything. It's been sanded down. It's got the fender well in it with tubbed out fender wells. Let me stop this music. And but anyways, these are just a couple of the ones I'm working on. This is the frame. Now this one, by the way, the engine, these are solder headers I've made. Billet aluminum pulleys from Detail Master. Billet fan blades, supercharged. The alternator I'm working on right now, so that's why the belt just kind of stops right there on the alternator bracket. It's hard to see, I know. I don't know if this is going to zoom in or give me a very good representation with this camera, but the alternator I'm working on right now actually has the even the blades are in aluminum, the blades of the alternator. It's hard to see it. Shit, I know this is not going to work right, but metal pulleys for that as well. So then that will go there inside of the bracket right there. You know, it'll be mounted in the bracket with everything else, so then that will look right. But it's got wire looms for the flame. It's got a etched flame valve covers, which the valve covers I made from scratch, but then there's a plate that Detail Master makes that has flame etching on it, which I just superimposed in the middle of it, so it kind of gives it a nice, you know, block style hot rod valve covers out of aluminum. Trying to make it as much aluminum as possible. And then of course the Civic engine is gonna have, it's already wired up, it's got fuel injectors already on it. Let's go and turn on the light. I don't know if you can see anything there with that light on or not, but the fuel injectors are there. Point them out, I guess. They're right. The fuel injectors are there. All the spark plugs have boots for the wires. Gosh, this is hard to see. I wonder if I took photos and just did it that way. Anyways. And then the suspension system for the F-150. I'm in the middle of creating the body drop frame, which I've taken pretty much all I did for the frame was I actually, all of it's made from strip styrene What I did with though was I cut off the body mount brackets off the factory molded one and used that to kind of help with the undercarriage of the F-150. So right now I've channeled the floorboard and I'm getting that ready for the body drop and everything, so the drive shaft will fit through. Just everything you have to do to a real truck to get it body drop is what I'm doing here. Again, using Detail Master, cross-drilled rotors, metal cross-drilled rotors. I've got airbags in here, all of which are hinged and pinned, so the suspension will be completely movable, turnable suspension. The tie rods have been cut apart. The tie rods have been cut apart. The lower control arms are pinned and hinged, so the tie rods will, once I've got those pretty much, as you can see, they actually do work. Everything is functional. So once these are done and I get the upper control arms, which will have to be tubular, I'll have that pretty much set up. So this is what I'm working on right now, is the F-150. Right now I'm getting ready to do the chopped rear end. I'm going to add these rims. They're pretty wide, so they'll have it'll sit in the bed of the truck. Do a quick mock-up here, so that the bed of the truck, when it's sitting there, will have basically a nice deep dish, you know, set up to it. So that'll be kind of the style of the rear end of the truck. So it'll have the Mustang style 5 spokes in deep dish, and then the a lot narrower versions to go in the front, which I've had to cut down. I've still got to work on that and get it flushed out more, and then all that. So that's the rear. These will be the front, which will mount. So you'll have nice cross-drilled rotors with Brembo brakes all the way around, and then that'll be the engine for it. The cherry bombs I made from scratch, the headers and the collector, they actually have flanges. I'll have to get a better camera to get the detail, but anyways. And again, this is the Honda Accord model I'm in the middle of building. I know it's hard to see it, but it's there. I know. It just takes forever. I work on different projects, and I have to kind of take my time and get the, like, that's the netting, the bracket for the netting, window netting, is made out of more wire and more flanges and gussets, and then of course the padding around the thing. All of this is a lot from the kit, but there's a lot of interior parts that are missing right now, but the MSD ignition system and everything is there. The turbo timers, boost gauges, various switches, various different control modules and mechanisms are built into. I use soda cans for the sheet metal, and then created, you know, built the sheet metal with the opening doors to see more inside of the dash. So anyways, I know this video probably sucks.